Okay, welcome back, Russ Scala, author of The American Biohacker, the book here on the shelf.
And hi, Ben.
Hi, Russ. Welcome back. And today we wanted to talk with you about brain rehab, nootropics, and microdosing LSD. So start us up on that. What is that all about?
Please like and subscribe. Thank you.
And hit that notification bell so you won't miss anything.
Yeah, I think this is going to be something that's going to come full circle with the Rolling Stone article with people in Silicon Valley, these high-level executives using sub-perpetual dosing of LSD to enhance their brain chemistry. I think it's going to be a tool not only to help repattern the brain, but we're looking right now at LSD and psilocybin for post-traumatic stress disorder. When I work with police officers and war veterans, I know that when they're in the war zone and they have PTSD, those memories are really, really hard to get out of their head. A lot of times what it's called, Stephen, it's called a flashbulb image. When you see something very traumatic, it imprints in your long-term storage. And we know that you're in a traumatic event long enough, it will cause the amygdala to grow and it will shrink the prefrontal cortex over time. So we know that Prozac, Paxil, and Zoloft can damage the prefrontal cortex at the level of the mitochondria. So we know that LSD and psychedelics have been used for thousands of years with other cultures. What we know is Albert Hoffman discovered LSD in 1936, and through an accident, he went on a trip. He experienced brain changes that he never experienced before, and he went on to use it to cure alcoholics in 5 Saskatchewan hospitals in the 1950s. And what a lot of people don't realize that is that LSD has been studied more than pretty much any drug on the market, including insulin. Using sub-perpetual dosing of LSD and psilocybin, these are tools to use to enhance somebody's brain chemistry that has been in a traumatic event. Enhance somebody's brain chemistry and repattern the brain, it allows certain parts of the brain to talk to each other that never talked before. And there's actually psychedelic guides. You could pay some of the psychiatrists and psychologists now in different parts of the US that will guide you through a psychedelic tour to help repattern your brain. And this is very effective. In order to take a trip, a dose would be 100 to 400 micrograms. A sub-perpetual dose would be 10 micrograms. So if you look at a grain of rice and you cut that grain of rice in 3 pieces, a sub-perpetual dose to enhance your brain chemistry would be a third of that rice. So we know that a lot of medications out there right now can damage the prefrontal cortex. We need more natural nootropics to help people with their brain chemistry. We know that nicotine and caffeine together slow the symptoms of Parkinson's disease. We know that the ketogenic diet stops epilepsy. We knew that in the early 1920s. So I think everything is coming full circle. LSD got the same bad rap as steroids. We know steroids save lives. Cholesterol is the number one steroid, and it saves lives. So we have to get people to start thinking about this. There's a Rolling Stone article about microdosing LSD that shows you how to develop a program to repattern your brain and what the Silicon Valley high-level executives are doing. There's a lot of computer coders and gamers that are in front of a computer. I've worked with some of these guys. They're in front of the computer 8, 24, 48 hours, and they end up getting put on an antidepressant and sleeping pills because being in front of a computer that long repatterns the brain. So these guys are diagnosed with mental illness like bipolar. These computer programmers, Bill Gates said it best, a really good computer programmer is worth 10,000 times the money of a normal programmer. So I have guys that we're trying to keep healthy that may be the guy that's developing the next billion-dollar app. And if they go south, the company goes south. So because I'm an 11th-hour interventionist and I get computer coders that they don't have that flow, they have to be, you know, a really good programmer has to be in a state of flow in order to write that code. So what I'm doing right now is I'm developing a treatment protocol using TRT, microbiome, looking at the mitochondria. and help them with nootropics that focus on their brain. And everybody's a little different, but I do believe the sub-perpetual dosing of LSD at 10 to 15 micrograms, we're going to see that as a tool, which is already being utilized in different parts of the U.S. There's been 26 million people that have tried LSD, and it's been documented since 2006. There are extreme benefits to this, and it's a lot safer than an SSRI, an SNRI. So again, we have to clean the chalkboard in our head. We have to reevaluate this stuff as tools because, Stephen, the reason we do TRT, think about it, we want to age gracefully. We don't want to end up in a nursing home. And I've been in hundreds of nursing homes in my career. Nothing sticks with me longer than a guy sitting in a recliner staring at the TV and he's totally out of it. That's heartbreaking. So I think these treatment protocols, my focus is on TRT dementia, sub-perpetual dosing of LSD to repattern the brain, whether it's post-traumatic stress or CTE or traumatic brain injury. I think these are going to be tools. And I've sat with the best neurologists in the country and walked through this, and they're still not on the same page with this, Stephen. So I think there's going to be a lot of opportunity for us here to educate people around the world to these new treatment protocols.
Yeah, for sure. But what about the legality of LSD? Can one just purchase it, or is that via a doctor or only in specialized clinics?
Well, I think they're using it in specialized clinics that I'm in contact with. I mean, I consult with an addiction center right now. I'm moving into an addiction center to use TRT and the opiate bowel and to develop advanced brain nootropic programs. I see this as a tool. There's clinical studies right now in psilocybin and PTSD. I think this is starting to come out full circle. Like I said, LSD's got the same bad rap as testosterone does. We just got to change the thinking in people's minds, Stephen, with real science.
Mm-hmm. And maybe one last thing. What over-the-counter nootropics could you recommend for everyone for to be sharp, mental focus, and so on?
Well, one of the things I like the ketogenic diet and fasting because fasting actually elevates GABA levels. Low dose nicotine, 2 milligrams. If you're focusing on something, the low dose nicotine has helped people focus. It helped with their brain chemistry in 2 to 3 hour intervals. Some people have their blood sugar drop when they're not used to nicotine, so you got to be careful with it. But nicotine, caffeine, a very very hot topic. Being in a fasted state. And it improves your GABA levels in your brain. When you switch to the ketogenic diet and your brain is burning the ketone called beta-hydroxybutyrate, you get more focus. You've got more focus than ever before. So my high-functioning problem solvers, my coder people, these guys are artists. And there's a lot of social isolation with these guys because nobody gets them. They're working 24/7. They've got a specific personality. If they're not developing code, they're home working on a new app and they don't really integrate into society really well. You know, they're kind of quirky. And I understand that. And I'm not judging anybody, but I think some of these most brilliant people that use these nootropics helps them avoid antidepressants because the coders that I've worked with right now were taking sleeping pills at night just to shut their brain off. And Stephen, that's not healthy over time for these guys.
Mm-hmm. Exactly. Okay. Thank you so much. Anything more you wanted to add for the viewers?
No, guys, I love being here. Thanks for all the docs accepting me. Thank you, Stephen. Thanks, Danny. Danny is amazing. I mean, he's spot on with a lot of his research. He's an IT guy. So I think we got to make friends with IT guys because this content is a new oil and nobody gets it out faster than an IT guy.
Yeah, we sure do. And Russ, of course, for the viewers that wouldn't know, the link is under the video. Russ is talking about the closed Facebook group, TRT and Hormone Optimization Therapy, HOT. It's a closed Facebook group that you can join. The group is growing fast. We are 450 members for the moment. We grew very fast the last few months. All the docs like Dr. Keith Nichols came in. Ruskala is there to help out. Dr. Meryl Matschke, Rob Komeniarek, and behind the screens even Dr. Neil Rousier and Eric Serrano are helping out or consulting with Keith. So all these guys are there to help you. You can join. And if you have any questions, come there, and we also post the latest research. So welcome to you all, and thanks again, Russ, for being in the group and helping out.
Yeah, I love this group. It's just probably the best TRT group in the world. And I can tell you this, guys, I'm very curious, and I take deep dives into things, so I don't know it all, but I love being here, and I'll share everything with you guys moving forward that I pick up.
Okay, thank you so much, and talk to you next time, Russ.
Bye.